Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. I'm going to show you an alternative way to multiply two numbers together using a grid or a box. Before doing it, we have to already know how to write the expanded form of a number. For instance, 342. The 3 is in the hundreds place, so that's 342. So, first of all, it's important that we know how to write a number in this expanded form. And the other thing we have to know is how to multiply numbers that end in zeros. So, if I have 30 times 40, the way to do this is if there, with the extra zeros, you put it at the end of the number and then you just get to do 3 times 4. So this would be 1200. If I, let's say, had 5 times 70, there's one zero, and then you just do 5 times 7 to get 350. So those are the two things you have to already know. All right, so let's see how this works. All right, so let's say you want to multiply 28 times 35. If you've got two digits times another two digits, what you need to do is make a box so that it's got two boxes by two boxes. And you want to make them kind of big. So they don't have to be long going the vertical, but you want to have them long this way. All right. And what we want to do is say we are multiplying 28, and I'm going to put that at the top as 20 plus 8. Okay, that's what 28 stands for. And then we're going to multiply that by 35. So on the side, and it doesn't matter which side, I'm going to put it on the left, that's the same as 30 plus 5. Now you don't have to put the plus sign there, but I just wanted to show you that's the number 28 and that's the number 35. All you really have to do is write 28, 35. And when you multiply 28 times 35, if you know a little bit of algebra, which you don't need to know to do this problem, what we're kind of doing is the distributive or FOIL method for multiplying these numbers together. We're thinking of it as 20 plus 8 times the 30 plus 5. There's actually four multiplications that go on here. So we see the 20, we have to multiply by each number over here. So 20 times 30. And what is that? Well, remember there's a zero and another zero, so there's two zeros. And then I just do 2 times 3, which is 6. Now I want to get this number down here. 20 times 5. There's only one zero, and I kind of want to line up your place values here. So put the zero here, and then 2 times 5 is 10. Okay? All right, we have to do this also with 8. We have to multiply 8 by each number over on the left. So 8 times 30, there's one extra zero. We have 8 times 3, which is 24. So 8 times 30 is 240. And then 8 times 5 is 40. So you're careful with your adding your numbers. You want to line up your place values here. Now, in each column that's in the boxes, you want to add those numbers. So I have 600 plus 100, that's 700. And 240 plus 40 is 280. Our final answer is to add everything we get down here at the bottom. So I'm going to go over on the side now. 700 plus 280 is 980. And that's the answer to 28 times 35. I hope. Now, in some other videos, I showed you how to do this with a lattice method. That's an alternative way to do it. And then, of course, there's just the kind of natural way they teach you in school, which I think it's harder to get the right answer to, but it takes less space on the paper. And so it's the traditional way of doing it. This is non-traditional, but it's actually easier on your brain, I think. So let's try another one. Okay, this time we've got three digits times two digits, so I want to make a grid with three boxes by two boxes. And it's easier to put the longer number across the top, okay? So I'm going to put three boxes across the top and then the two boxes across the side. So I want to have, remember, 537 is 537. So I want to make these kind of big enough fact, I might not have made that big enough. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. Right, so across the top, we're going to put 537. And along the side, we're multiplying it by 24. Right, so what goes in the box? I need to do the 500 times the 20. There's three extra zeros, so we put the three zeros. And then we have 5 times 2, which is 10. Now we do 500 times 4. There's two extra zeros. We have 5 times 4, which is 20. So if you want, you could add this column up right now. That's going to be what? 12,000. We know we're going to add it to what we get at the bottom of each column. All right, let's do 30 times 20 now. Well, we've got two extra zeros, right? And so the 3 times 2 is 6. We're doing 30 times 4. There's one extra zero. So we have 3 times 4, which is 12. Let's add that up right now. That's 720. And then we're going to do 20 times 7. So there's one zero. 7 times 2 is 14. And 7 times 4 is 28. We add up these two numbers, so I get 168. So to get my final answer, I've got to multiply, I have to add these three numbers up. So I'm just going to put it under the 1200. We've got the 12, I'm under the 12,000. So I've got 12,000, add the 720 and the 168. And you could add right to left or left to right. In another video I did, I taught how to add from left to right, so I'm going to do it that way, but you could do it from right to left. So I'm going to get 1, 2, 8, 8, 8. So that should be the answer if I didn't make any mistakes, which of course sometimes I do. All right, let's try another one. All right, this time I have a 3-digit times a 3-digit, so I'm going to have a big old box here, right? I'm going to have 3 by 3. So it's going to be pretty big. So we're going to have 400, 30, 1 across the top. And then on the side, I've got 265. All right, so now we have to fill in all these multiplications. So I have 400 times 200. There's four zeros that are going to go at the end, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I just do 4 times 2, which is 8. All right, now I'll do the 400 times the 60. So I've got three extra zeros. And 4 times 6 is 24. And then 400 times 5, I've got two extra zeros. And 4 times 5 is 20. And let's go ahead and add that up. That's 10, 6, 0, 0, 0. Right? Three extra zeros for all of them. That adds up to 6 and 10. Okay, looks good so far. Plus, right, and now we have to do 30 times all the numbers on the left. Okay, so 30 times 200, there's three extra zeros, right? And 30, I mean, 3 times 2 is 6. So 30 times 200 is 6,000. Then we've got 30 times 60, we've got two extra zeros. 3 times 6 is 18. And then 30 times 5, we have one extra zero. 3 times 5 is 15. So let's say we add that up. So we've got the 5, 9, and 7. And now let's do 1 times this number. That'll be easy. 1 times 200 is just 200. 1 times 60 is 60. 1 times 5 is 5. So of course that's just going to add up to 265, that number itself. So now all I have to do is add up those three numbers together, and I'll just put it underneath here, the 7950. Oh, I put the comma in the wrong place here. Oops. Okay, so we've got 7950 and the 265. And now we have to add those three numbers up together. And you can add from left to right or right to left. So go ahead and do that addition on your own, and I'm going to do it using a left to right method. That's a 1 and a 0, and then 6 and 7 is 13. So I'm going to write that 13 here. 9 and 2 is 11. 5 and 6 is 11. And that's a 5. So get 1, 1, 4, 2, 1, 5. Okay, let's see. Let's see if you did it the old-fashioned way, the way they teach you in school. 106,750 into 65. If we go right to left with carrying, let's see, you got a 5. This is 11, carry the 1. This is 11, carry the 1 is 12, carry the 1. So that's 13, 14, carry the 1. So that's a 1 and that's a 1. So, okay. So either way we look at it, we're going to get 114,215. And that is the grid or box way of multiplying numbers so that you don't have to do all that multiplying and carrying in your head. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.